Subscribe and click the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications from the Indian Express.
Time and again, films become a matter of public discourse after running into trouble with the Central Board of Film Certification. Recently, CBFC earned the ire of the Bombay High Court for refusing U certification to a film produced by the Children's Film Society. "You're a certification board, not a censor board," Bombay HC told the CBFC, once again reviving the curiosity around how films get certified. Here's how. The CBFC is headed by a chairperson. The board has up to 25 members and comprises 60 advisory panel members from across India, appointed by the INB Ministry. The chairperson and the board members are eligible to serve for 3 years, while the advisory panel members serve for 2 years. The chairperson, or the CEO, is responsible for the administrative functioning of the body, but it's the regional officers who certify films via examining committees. A short film, which is any film with a duration below 72 minutes, requires a member of the advisory panel and an examining officer, one of whom has to be a woman. A feature film with duration above 72 minutes needs 4 members of the advisory panel and examining officer, of who 2 persons have to be women.
Getting certification, you need to apply with more than, you have to pay more than 25,000 rupees. Okay. And also, you need to pay some PCP, you need to make these people comfortable, giving them refreshments.
There are 4 types of certifications given by the CBFC. U for unrestricted public exhibition. UA for parental guidance for children below the age of 12. A for adult. S for viewings by special groups. The rating is decided by the regional officer based on reports of examining committee members, unanimity or majority. In case the opinion on a film is split, the decision rests with the chairperson. The reason cited for awarding Chidiyakhana a UA certificate was that it had scenes of murder, goons and guns, use of abusive language, a scene where children watch an adult song on the mobile, a mother slapping a child, a suicide attempt, winking at a woman, and discrimination faced by North Indians in Mumbai. Similarly, in 2016, John Favreau's The Jungle Book was given a UA certificate for being considered too dark, which resulted in widespread criticism. The CBFC cannot censor anything. It can only share a list of suggested changes with the applicant. If the applicant is unhappy with the certification, he or she can apply to the revising committee. The revising committee comprises a chairperson and up to 9 members from the board and the advisory panel. A similar process is followed, with the final word resting with the chairperson. The final place for an applicant to appeal against the certification is the Appellate Tribunal. The Appellate Tribunal, also known as the FCAT, Film Certification Appellate Tribunal, is an independent body appointed by the INB Ministry for a term of 3 years. The CBFC can, quote, direct the applicant to carry out such excisions or modifications in the film as it thinks necessary before sanctioning the film for public exhibition, or refuse to sanction the film for public exhibition, unquote. The film shall meet all the demands of Section 5B of the Cinematograph Act 1952 and Article 19 of the Constitution. The section states, quote, a film shall not be certified if any part of it is against the interest of the sovereignty and integrity of India, the security of the state, friendly relations with foreign states, public order, decency, or involves defamation or contempt of court, or is likely to incite commission of any offence, unquote. There's obviously more than one way to read the section, therefore making it one of the most hotly debated sections during certification battles.
In my experience, I feel that they are actually going beyond their power only because of this weird open vague suggestions, this vague provisions of this act.